Let's load up the bombs.
Test your intuition about motion on this problem. Sometimes gliding enthusiasts practice flower bombing an airfield target.
Open.
Slow down now.
First, they have to load up with flour, and then get pulled up into the sky to become airborne. There's little wind around to affect the path of the flower bomb once it's been dropped. So the question is, at what point should the flower bomb be released to hit a particular target? Many people's intuition suggests releasing the flower bomb when the glider is almost directly over the target. But that doesn't work. In fact, you have to release the flower bomb well before the glider is over the target. Let's see that again. If you consider the case of a glider travelling at 50 kilometres per hour at a height of, say, 50 metres, then the flower bomb would have to be released at a point at least 40 metres before the target. Our intuition about motion can easily let us down. Here's a simple experiment. This pink bean bag is twice as heavy as each of these two blue ones. So, if I take the heavy bean bag and one of the light ones and let them fall from the same height at the same moment, which do you think will hit the ground first? Well, contrary to what intuition might suggest, they both hit the ground at the same time. Possibly that surprised you. Many of our intuitive ideas about motion are wrong, and yet they were embodied in the theories of one of the greatest thinkers in history, Aristotle. Aristotle lived in Greece in the 4th century BC. He was a pupil of Plato and tutor to Alexander the Great.